Hi guys and welcome to Softskins. This video is about pandas and how to get a random sampling of your data frame. We are going to demonstrate how to get random rows, random columns and how to do sampling by grouping. In this article you can find all the steps described for this purpose and the steps have some advanced examples. We are going to do demonstration of all of them and we are going to use dataset for movies. In order to make the basic sampling of your data frame, you can use method sample and by default it's going to return only one row, as you can see here in this cell. If you want to get number of rows different than one, then you can provide this number as integer. And now we get three random rows from this data frame. If you want to get not rows but columns from this data frame, you can provide parameter axis equal to 1. And in this case, we are going to get only 3 random columns from this data frame. Let's say that you don't want to get number of rows, but you want to get fraction or percentage from your data frame. Then you can use frac parameter and provide the fraction. In this case, we have 5000 rows. Approximately, and by providing this fraction we get only 5 results, and this is how fraction is working. And then you can use a random state in order to provide some seed for your sample, and this is going to change the seeds and the sampling. And now let's say that you want to use something different and implement your own solution. In this case, you can use np-random and choice in order to get random data from your data frame. In this case, we have data frame with 5000 rows, but we're going to get random rows only from the first 1000. And we're going to get size of 5 rows. And as you can see, we have 5 random rows from our first 1000 examples. And if you want to get a random sample based on some column values, let's say we have a column color and we have several different options for this column, you can use a code like this, where you're going to list all unique values for your column and then you're going to iterate through all of them and finally you're going to display samples for each of them. In this case, you can see that we have example for color and black and white. But as you can guess, if we have none values, we will not get a result for them because we have drop an A here. And you might need to do some changes in order to make this work because sometimes you might have problems working with none values. And let's say that you have more than 2 or several values and you want to display them grouped in a single data frame. Again, we are going to list all variants for a given column, in this case content rating. Then we are going to iterate through all of them. We are going to generate sample data and we are going to append it to a list of data frames. Finally, we are going to concatenate all those data frames in a single one. And as you can see right now, we have all those variants for this data frame. And we are generating one single row for each of them. And you can see here the content rating and that we have only one row per each of them. And now let's say that you want to do something similar but using weights. And this is possible by method sample in pandas data frame. But we need to build a list of weights and we can do this by using npWare. In this case, we are going to work again with color column. We are checking, is this column equal to color? If yes, give weight 0. If not, give weight 1. Finally, we are going to provide the list of examples to this method. And we want to get only 5 results. And as you can see, we have different rows based on this, but we don't have color. And in this case, we will get none values if we continue to play with this cell or at least we are expected to get some values with none, but let's we already have, but since none values are small amount of the black and white values comparing to none values, that's why we get them with less probability. You can change this again with playing with weight. And now let's say that we want to get samples only for color. In this case we are just switching the probabilities and we'll get random values only for colors. How this is working, let's do a quick demonstration of NPWare. We are giving the column and condition for this column. We want to get all values which are equal to color. In this case we are going to provide number 1, otherwise we provide 0. And we are working with this slice of the data frame. As you can see we have 110. And let's check the values for this data frame. As you can see here we have black and white and we have none. And in case that we have color we will have 1, otherwise we will have 0. And this is how the NPWare and the weights are working. And you can use this technique in order to get list of values or subset of this list. Let's say that we don't want to get all values from this list of variants for content rating, but we want to get only these 3 of them. Then we can provide this list with isin, giving probability 1 for them, otherwise we will get 0. Finally, we are going to provide the list of weights to parameter weights of this sample method. And let's check what we have. As you can see, again we have list of some samples. In this case we have fraction 002, but we have some of them which are more often than others. And if you want to check why this is happening, you can use value counts and check that we have most of them are PG-13, some of them are PG and less are G. And that's why this is the distribution. If you want to change this, you can play with the weights in order to get better result for you. And finally, let's say that you want to get panda sample rows by group. And we are going to use column color. In this case, we are going to group by this column and then we are going to apply lambda. And in this lambda, we are using the sample method, which is going to return only 3 rows for each group. And as you can see, we have a group of black and white and we have a group for color. And there should be a random representatives of their groups. We can execute it again and you can see that index is changing. But if you don't like this way of multi-indexing, then you can reset the index and create a new data frame for you by using reset index drop equal true. And in this case you're going to get completely new data frame with sample from the original data frame. And the final bonus which I wanted to mention for data sampling in pandas is that sometimes you may start with getting the first and the last rows of your data frame. And in this way you can combine head and tail in order to get them in only a single cell, not in several cells. This can be done by using append and appending the head results and the tail results. In this case we are providing parameter 2, which means that we want only 2 rows from our sampling, first 2 and last 2, and this is what we have. And we have a bit more than 5000 rows, not how we thought initially. So that's all for data sampling with pandas. If you have new ideas how to do sampling or if I miss something, please write it in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and see you next time.